pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it.
Your R&D team has been working non-stop this season. Is this to catch up or stay ahead? Do you think this team are performing as well as they could do?
Appreciate your time.
We're in Belgium once again for today's round of the Formula One World Championship. It's a race the great Ayrton Senna won 6 times, and in 2019, Charles Leclerc became the first driver to take their maiden win here since Michael Schumacher in 1992. Spa-Francorchamps today, a circuit that spans 4.35 miles. There are tons of elevation changes along the way too. 19 corners making up this circuit, with 9 of those to the right and the remaining 10 to the left. This track is a great one for fans of pure speed. The average lap speed comes close to a whopping 145 miles an hour. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are 3 main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and P2 goes to Daniel Ricciardo, a strong showing from the Australian. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Charles Leclerc, and Vettel. Hamilton, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Gasly, Sainz, and Lance Stroll. Norris, they've taken a grid penalty. Fernando Alonso, Moore and Ocon. Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher and George Russell. Latifi and Nikita Mazepin. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Okay, you're in the top 10. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
A difficult race then on one of the all-time classic circuits, but they persevered to take the win here today. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Quick look at how the driver standings have changed. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
Made it look easy. You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy?
It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? You had a close battle today, didn't you?
Appreciate your time.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.